CIS scholars, how are you all? Are you taking care of yourself? Are you fit and fine? Children, I am Miss Neelam Modi, your social science educator. And yes, if you ask me, how are you, ma'am? I am all right and I am fit and fine. Children, we are going to do lesson number 4, part 3, that is India's physical feature, part 2, and this is the third video of our chapter. Okay, so are you all excited to know? Okay, children, so let's start.
Okay, grade 4 children, we are starting with the third video of India's physical feature part 2, right? And we have completed two videos of this chapter, and here we are going to start in this video by recalling the last things what we have studied in the last video. So first we have seen that planinsula patty is triangular in shape, right? Kaun se shape ka hota hai? Triangular in shape. Then we have seen that it is divided into two parts. Peninsula plateau ke do parts hote hai, central highland and the Deccan plateau. Kaun se do part hote hai? Central highland and Deccan plateau. Central highland mein aur do part hote hai. Central highland includes Malwa plateau and Chota Nagpur plateau. Kya hota hai central highland mein? Malwa plateau and Chota Nagpur plateau. Malwa plateau is in the western part of the central highland. And Chota Nagpur plateau is in the eastern part of the central highland. Okay, children. So this was all about the brief what we have studied in the last video. Now we'll go ahead today with the Deccan plateau and importance of the Deccan plateau. So let's start first with the Deccan plateau. Children, Deccan plateau extends from Satpura range in the north and Kanyakumari till the south. मतलब यहाँ जो Satpura range है, वहाँ से Deccan plateau start होता है, यहाँ से Deccan plateau start होता है till the Kanyakumari in the south. इतना extend होता है. Then children, वहाँ पे बहुत सारे on the western part of the plateau there are many hills. कौन से hills होते हैं? You can see here Sayadri hills होते हैं, Nilgiri hills होती है, Anamalai होती है and Cardamom hills यहाँ पे होते हैं. So these are the western part of the plateau जहाँ पे Sayadri, Nilgiri, Anamalai and Cardamom. These are the name of the hills which are found in the Deccan plateau. Okay? Moreover, these hills form the western ghats. ये सारी hills से क्या बनता है? Western ghat. What it makes? Western ghats. Now children, you should know that Annaimalai, which is located in the Kerala, is the highest peak of the western ghat. मतलब जो Annaimalai है, जो western ghat में है, that is the highest peak of the western ghat, where it is located in the Kerala, and the eastern part of the plateau is all bordered by the eastern ghats. Simple, ठीक है, eastern part में eastern ghats है और western ghat में highest peak किस चीज का है? Annaimalai का. Okay, now the climate of the Deccan plateau also varies. वहाँ पे climate same नहीं होती है. Some places have semi-arid climate while other have the warm climate. Semi-arid means moderate type climate होती है और कभी कभी वहाँ पे बारिश कब होती है? Drizzles rainfall from June to October. कब बारिश होती है? From June to October. Now rivers जो होती है, कौन सी rivers flow होती है? सबसे ज्यादा वहाँ पे महानदी, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. You can see here Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and यहाँ पे नीचे Kaveri होती है. So these rivers flow through the Deccan plateau. Okay? Now these rivers flow from west to east and drains into West Bengal. ये river west to east होती है और कहाँ पे flow होती है? खत्म कहाँ पे होती है? Bay of Bengal में. And there are many hill stations. Which hill stations are located? कुर्ग है, कोडाई कनल है, इडुकी, ऊटी, वायनंद आर सम ऑफ द फेमस हिल स्टेशन. कुर्ग इज वेरी गुड प्लेस, देन कोडाई कनल है, इडुकी है, ऊटी है. दीज आर द हिल स्टेशंस ऑफ द डेक्कन प्लेट्यू. नाउ वी विल गो अहेड विद द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ द पेनिनसुलर प्लेट्यू. पेनिनसुलर प्लेट्यू के क्या इम्पोर्टेंस होते हैं? विल सी दैट. Okay. So first important point is the Ghats have many forests which provides woods and medicine. वहाँ पे बहुत अलग अलग type के woods और medicines provide होती है. Then these forests are home to many animals such as sambar deer, hyenas, nilgai, sloth bear, nilgiri thar, elephants, tigers and Indian giant squirrels. ये सब animals वहाँ पे form होते हैं. कहाँ पे? वो घाट्स में जहाँ पे peninsula plateau है, western and eastern घाट्स में. और यहाँ पे ये सारे different types of animals होते हैं. I've kept the picture of Nilgiri thar, how it looks. Okay, so in this way there are many other different types of animals are found in the peninsula plateau. Then children, the crops which are grown over here are chickpea, sugar cane, groundnut and millets. These are the crops which are grown in the peninsula plateau. There are many hill stations in this plateau which attract tourists. वहाँ पे बहुत ज़्यादा hill stations भी है जो tourists के लिए attract करते हैं और लोग वहाँ को पे देखने आते हैं. Okay children, and last point is many important minerals are found in this region. These regions are very rich in minerals as we have seen, and so that's why very important minerals are found in this region. So this was all about your Deccan Plateau and importance of Peninsular Plateau. Your homework is hard words you have to write down in the notebook. I'll be sending you the hard words through the PDF format and you have to write down in the notebook. Okay, so in the next video we'll start with the new topic of this chapter. Till then, write the hard words properly and make the proper notes. Bye bye.